And that's what mattered. Annalise Love.
What's the
laboratorios sensoriales, permanezca sentado en brazos, pies y piernas dentro del rincón y cuide los pequeñitos. Gracias.
Does it go upside down?
It does go upside down.
Does it go upside down?
It does.
Dr. Michael Channing, chairman of the Imagination Institute. Hello. On your tour, you'll see how the five human senses can help capture your imagination.
Oh, can I go too?
Absolutely not. This is one of our discoveries, the figment of imagination.
Yeah, I know all about the senses. There's sight, sound, smell, touch, goochie goochie goo, and taste. Tastes like chicken. Can I go? Please, please.
It's figment.
Figment? I thought I told you not to interfere.
But you've got it wrong, Doc. It's not about listening with your ears. It's about listening with your imagination.
Now I've come. Let's begin by using the eye chart to test your vision. Now, all together, if you would please read line three.
With L-I-G-L-E-N-T, you can see things differently.
I say imagination must be captured and controlled.
Uh-huh. Imagination works best when it's
imagination, especially when pleasant, familiar smells
come into play. I'd love to.
This is not a good time.
It's always a good time to use your imagination. So let the good times roll. Woohoo! You win 1 cent.
Just like that.
Now here's a real open house. Come on in. So what do you think? Is it me?
Works the best when it's set free.
You said it, Doc. Imagination is a blast.
Everybody's getting in on this one. All right, headed to Living with Land. We're gonna do Soarin'.
Haywire.
We'll try to with David for the first time.
It's like,
and obviously Living with Land, which is Mama's favorite.
It was good, wasn't it?
What movie?
I fell asleep. Right, Mandy? Favorite ride? Her happy place.
Beneath the surface of the land, roots trap water from the flowing mud.
extracting precious nutrients and minerals. These elements. Harsh conditions make use of what little water they can find and avoid the scorching rays of the relentless sun. Humans have had one of the most profound effects. The need to produce food for a growing world led to the enormous use and sometimes overuse of the land. In our search for more efficient ways to grow food, we often fail to realize the impact of our methods. The tropics are. These are just a few of the edible plants that have been an important source of nutrition for people living in the tropics. Lesser-known tropical plants may be as important as the bananas growing on both sides of the boat. More than 20... account for nearly two-thirds of our global food consumption. Learning how to increase yields of these staples is an important goal of research around the world. Things like these increase yields while more efficiently using resources like water, fertilizer, and pesticides. Populating our greenhouses with beneficial insects that prey on been inspired by nature, like these fruit and vegetable trees. By growing these ground plants vertically, we can keep the water clean for the fish. It's another great way to produce more while using less.
All right, we're about to go on Soren. David's another first time with Soren. You ready for Soren? Where are we doing? Where are we going?
Fly on an airplane.
Fly on an airplane. Ready? All right. Let's see how he likes it. You're tall enough?
I think I am.
I think I am. All right, you got it. You went. David.
He stole the sticker back from me. He's like, this is mine.
He loves his ski. It was nice. I know. I always went to try to play another one, but I was like, no one's going to have a good story.
That's like Indiana Jones.
He's watching the map of where we're going. It's very mesmerized. Right, David? He's mesmerized by this map. I told him this is where we're going to be going. Oh, guess what we got?
Noodle Row.
And we also got...
Oh, we got another Guardians Pass.
Please take a seat. Store all carry-on items in the underseat compartment. This includes cameras, purses, hats, and of course, these little beauties.
Taking off.
Oh, Dede. Woo! happen?
Thanks. Restore.
You like that?
Don't fasten your seatbelt.
You like that?
Yeah, are we going on the guide?
You gather all your carry-on items from the vendor seat compartment and exit to your right.
I just got done. Soren, which you saw.
We may have to do that one again.
Yeah. David loved it. He was scared. Loved it. Epcot was his favorite, probably.
He was screaming. He's probably going to crash soon.
You know, he's rubbing his eyes now. He was just right there. He, look.
Epcot.
Epcot.
First food options. Where we got it from?
The Mexican Pavilion.
The Mexican Pavilion.
Festival food. Char siu pork bun and General Tso's something something from the Painted Panda. You might like this one, David.
So far we've liked everything we've tried, but David has not. So we're gonna try to eat and get him something here. Right, Mama? You liked everything so far? Mm-hmm. Now, we knew we were gonna like it because we watched a vlog on it, so.
We have a whole.
Yes. How about us enjoyed it too? You ready, buddy?
Yeah.
Hungry?
That'd be really good. Will might actually go get some after your trip.
Mm. I want one.
Wanna try one?
Just take a bite.
Mama? Are you good?
That's good. Here.
So good.
It was top. What?
It was super good. Those noodles.
It's very good. Little secret place.
Yes. When you're hungry, we're not sure if it's because we're like starving or what. David, you like it? David. David. David, you want to be on camera? David. Did you like the noodles? Look at me. David, let me see it. Say cheese. All right, we got the braised short rib.
Yep.
And the cider. It's good. It was a W?
The win, bro.
Actually, I think it's the best thing we've had all night.
It's amazing. Like the broccolini has like a vinegar in it base, and the braised short rib, like you don't even have to cut it.
That's the best we've had all night.
It's amazing.
Let's see it. What did he say?
So we go to the bathroom to pee. And then he's like, I got pooped. So I'm like, all right, whatever. Let's go poop. And then he's sitting in there and he's pooping. And he's like, it's going to be 100 hours, Mama. You better start counting 100. Go ahead. I was like, no, I'm not counting 100. So then we finish, blah, blah, blah. He gets off the toilet. He's like, money in the pop. Money in the pop. Money. And I was like, what does that mean? What's that?
David,
money
are you
in
crazy?
The pop.
Money crazy? In the
I knew we were friends, so you'd get over it, but I also, you mentioned I was part of that classic girl. Shout more farewell, I guess there ain't a whole lot there yet, although perhaps it makes no sense. I strut my stuff with lots of confidence, and though I lack an awful lot, there is one thing I got positive.
Alright, we got a hummingbird cake from the artist palette and a sipping chocolate flight. So it's like three different hot chocolates. You can try it, David.
What does it taste like?
Chocolate.
Is it hot? It's basically like chocolate syrup.
Is it hot?
No, it's good. Hold it with two hands. What do you think? It's like hot chocolate syrup. It's not even like hot chocolate. It's hot chocolate syrup.
What's that there? Hold on.
Two hands.
I'll do it. I'll do it for you.
Oh my
How
God.
Is it?
It's so good. It's like fruity banana.
I'll do it for you. Yep. No, let me do it for you. Let me do it for you.
That's cold, so that's like a sorbet of some sort. Just two hands.
What
does
it taste like,
Mama?
Like
me. You look like Adolf Hitler.
Hitler.
Does it taste like, Mama?
This one's white chocolate.
No, Mr. Rock. I think you got that on video.
No, it's good.
Banned.
It's warm.
Cut that out. Nine.
Let's see it. Is it a chip?
Yeah. Oh, dear.
All right. Say thank you.
Thank you.
What's your name?
Sam G. Howard.
David. Look. David, that's your name in Japanese. Look at that. Is that cool? And a sticker? Say thank you. Test track? David Trish, I'm on test track. David, you ready?
Super tall, super tall.
Stand now. There's your car. Let's go.
W.
Surface.
how you design it.
Glimpsing sim car off road and extreme weather situations.
This is it of the vlog. Everybody's worn out.
I'm pooped.
We're all pooped. And we're gonna sleep.
We're here, Rip Drop, to close with early hours and extended evening hours.
So we're gonna go home and sleep it off. We still gotta go back to the Riviera on the gondola and walk to the truck. drive the truck over to Polly, get out of the truck, and go up to our room. So
we're 16 hours.
Yeah. And how many steps do we have? Probably 21,000, you said?
Probably.
About 21,000. So, just a little bit.